Alright. You know what? I did forget to do something important, but I'll have a chance to go fix the problem. I did forget to do something very important. What happens if I go down to floor one? Does it let me do that? I don't think this elevator reaches floor one. It won't open. Yeah, this doesn't go to floor one or two. There was no... Or it goes to floor two, but it won't go to floor three. Yeah, there was no place for a hidden security elevator on floors one or three. So who knows where it goes. Okay, back to floor two. That just takes you to a little hidden treasure room with some stuff in it. Good times. Let's get back out of here. We just have to trust the sound of Aya's feet that we can get out of the secret passage in a timely manner. Now that the alarm has been deactivated, I think I can go any hallways where she says you can't get through here. I think I can get through there now. Whoa, what? Cutscene? Eve is singing somewhere? That museum map on the wall right there in the cutscene, that's actually an accurate map. That's what the museum is shaped like and looks like. That's a detail I never noticed until very recently, actually. Until I sat down and drew my own maps and saw what the shape of each floor was. That's really cool. Because you don't get an in-game map in this. I don't like the look of this mitochondria slime headed for the Tyrannosaurus exhibit. Oh god, this is going to be bad. You know what this stuff looks like? This stuff looks like the syrup they use to make Coca-Cola. And Pepsi, I guess. I should say that. Someone will put it out in the comments. It looks just as gross in Pepsi Brickroad. I know. And you know what? I'm going to put it in my body. I don't care. Ah, refreshing. Bubbly and sweet. Not quite ice cold, though. That's how she controls an inanimate object. She's crazy! Exclamation point, exclamation point, exclamation point. I is just now figuring this out. But now I think we can go through this here. Yes, okay. So the museum has opened up a little bit. So we've been in this room earlier. So now we have to actually backtrack to Klamp's office, which will now also be open. Yep, I skipped a very important weapon modification step. We'll fix it, guys. It's okay. It's all good. Alright, Pterodon, you can go first. We'll let the armadillo live now. Unless I can get you both with burst. Oh, nice! Good shot. Get out of the way of that. Get out of the way of this, too. Burst again. I love it. Except they both backed out of range. Actually, that armadillo was behind the wall. I missed him completely. Beautiful. Got him with the burst shot just as he was rearing up to attack me. Gotta love that. Moving on. Past the gift shop. Like, every room that I've cleared, I've only got like a 50% chance to trigger another battle on it. Which makes it very inefficient if you're going to... Oh, the door's open! Very inefficient if you're going to actually grind up levels, which is pointless. There's really no reason to do that. So, I think I needed to clear my inventory out a little bit, too. Professor Klamp! You're under arrest, finally. Oh, wait, you're not Klamp. Unless Klamp killed Mida and is wearing his skin. This is like a plot hole, okay? If Mida needed to do some tests, why come back to the museum where he knows all the bad juju is going down? And why not just do the tests at the precinct? And also, how did he get into the museum when all the doors and stuff were locked? Anyway. I mean, the reason he's here, it's not a plot hole, it's like, the reason he's here is, he has to be here for the plot to work. Like, they needed Mida in this room for this cutscene, so. Mida's gun, attack power of room 1. You know what, Mida? Thanks. Thanks, bro. That's actually the one weapon you can't take with you across X games. Otherwise, it would be kind of cool to upgrade Mida's gun to the point where it's hundreds and hundreds of attack power and is super awesome in every conceivable way. But you can't do that. Unfortunate. It's a handgun, though, which was nice. Klamp just has a big ol' hard-on for Eve. It's just... a huge creepazoid. That's all he is. And, of course, he's behind us. Naturally. I don't like this character either. This archetype character, I mean, who's always like, you normal humans would never understand. Shut up, dork. You're a normal human just like the rest of us with a big old hook nose. Huh. I needed two empty inventory spots before this scene. Oh, crap. Get to a little bit more inventory management after this. That's too bad. It happens, though. He just called me pathetic, and then he acknowledged that I have superpowers. Oh, Dallas, you were hiding in the corner. Good to see you, bro. Glad to see your mustache is still shaggy and manly and wonderful. Wait, she was afraid he was going to stab her with a scalpel? She just shot an entire museum full of dinosaurs that spit burning ice, and she was upset about a scalpel? And what's Klomp's deal? He was going to attack her with a scalpel? She has a gun! Even if I hadn't been pouring bonus points into that gun for the past 20 hours, why on earth would you take a scalpel to it? Even if it's Midas gun with one attack power, I still beat you with a scalpel because I can hit you from across the room. I can shoot you 6 times for 6 points of damage each shot before you even close the distance. Klomp is a scientific genius who's an expert on the human body, and he came at me with a scalpel. Just saying. We should have known he was the bad guy from the beginning because of his... look at the shape of his beard, guys. Anybody who has a beard that points up at their mouth, nothing good comes out of that mouth. It's just a universal law. Uh-oh, Eve's pregos. This is bad. Everything's bad. And he's like, you humans are weak. You're a human, Klomp. As much as you wish you were a mitochondria monster, nanomachines, nanomachines, you're not. I'm sorry. You were just weak and pathetic as all of us, and we're about to find out for sure that that's true. Look at this. Quick, guys, jump out of the second story window. Tuck and roll. Maybe you won't break your spines. Uh-oh. Now Klomp's burning to death. Did he learn his lesson? Is he gonna repent now that he's on fire and smoking? No. He's gonna laugh at me. Oh, I had enough inventory space. Okay. It's actually really derpy if you don't have any inventory space, because the man's like burning, smoking alive. In fact, you can't even trigger him anymore after that. You can't talk to him or anything. If you don't have enough inventory space for the Klomp key, you have to make space for it and talk to him again to get the key. And he's just like, oh, I'm just smoldering here on the ground. That's okay. You can just go ahead and take care of what you need to do, Aya. And I'll still be here in a minute. Alright, where do we need to go now? I need to go back up to the third floor. The whole museum's open now. I can go wherever I want. The Klomp key will get me into any rooms that were previously locked. Whether or not we actually saw Klomp lock them is irrelevant. So we're going to go up the stairs here. We're going to get picked on by these terrible monsters. Let's get the lizards out of the way first. Oh, I waited too long. Oh, they're all burst, go! Could have been worse. At least I got one of the lizards. Then I got both lizards. Okay, stay out of lunging range, Aya. Nice. A medicine, too? Why would they drop that craziness? Okay, so that door is unlocked now. That gets us into this cool little corner room here. No, that door was already unlocked. Yeah, because this is the room we stepped into and Klomp locks us in. So I guess it was locked. I guess it was locked after we stepped in here. If we didn't have the Klamp key, we wouldn't be able to get in here. We're fine now, is the point. Oh, you know what? I might have to go all the way back around, to be honest. Yeah, the museum doesn't connect in this direction. That sucks. Alright, let's go fix it. I remember why now. Yeah, no, the museum does not connect in this direction. We actually have to backtrack a little bit. Going up these stairs doesn't get us anything yet, does it? No, because Eve's mitochondrial goo is blocking the doorway. Stick this medicine 2 in there, gross. For a medicine 5, what? Good stuff. When your auto heal kicks in, it takes the weakest medicine first, so it starts at the bottom, so... Which is nice. I think it does that anyway, maybe it doesn't. I'm pretty sure it does, though, so we actually have to circle all the way back around. It's a little time-consuming, because you have to go all the way around to the alarm room, then all the way back to Klamp's room, then all the way back around to the alarm room again, once you have the Klamp key, but the museum's more or less empty now. We've cleared every single hallway and room of monsters, so... Now, if you haven't been drawing a map, and you don't know which rooms you've explored and which rooms you haven't, how everything connects together, at this point in the museum, you have really no direction on where to go. There's one room on the map that you cannot reach without the Klamp key, and unless you've actually drawn it out or looking at a map, let's be honest, this game came out the era of GameFAQs. Was it GameFAQs? Yeah, GameFAQs was around when this game came out. RP Gamer might not have been, though. RP Gamer might have still been Square.net when this game came out. Holy crap, that was... Like, RP Gamer is a website that's kind of out of touch and obsolete by modern standards, but to think that it was another website even before that makes me feel super old. Okay, so we're in this room. This door gets unlocked now. And this is the only room that you can't reach. The southwest corner of the third floor you cannot reach in Parasite Eve without the Klamp key. You need the Klamp key to do it. Okay. So we're going to try to go through this door down here, but it's not going to work. Because evil triceratops. Okay, so we want to actually use energy shot on him, but we want to blow his head off first. This monster can do a lot of damage if you let it. Because dodging that electric attack is almost impossible, as far as I can tell. It spirals around in a kind of like a pseudo-random way, and it seems to always double back and hit you. Shot it while it was charging me, that was pretty cool. Getting a, Yeah, see, that time the spiral was much tighter. I was trying to stay inside of the spiral, but it didn't work. Might have to use up some healing items here. Yep, we did. Oh no, and it used the full cure first. Okay, so it actually does start at the top, not at the bottom. That's fine, though, because I don't have any other items that were going to heal 670 points of damage. Okay, now that I've knocked its horns off, and it's got this little stunty muscle head, I'm going to energy shot him. Which I thought for some reason would be enough to kill him, but it wasn't. But he's got to be getting close. I actually kind of want to drag this out a little bit and let my PE fill back up for a while, but it's not a big deal. Alright, Triceratops is dead. Level up. full recover, all HP and remove status, and we got 6 bullets back. Let's go ahead and heal up now. I will use up... Do I still have a med 2? No, I got rid of that. Let's use med 3s. And let's spend our bonus points. Nice. And just for good measure, let's go ahead and equip our AT-4. And carry on. But the Triceratops we just watched evaporate into nothing knocks us out the window, down into the gallery, which we know is where the T-Rex is. Ugh! Also, Aya just fell from a higher height. Earlier, she said if she falls from here, she's dead. But she wasn't. She fell from there, she's fine. She didn't even take any damage. Fall damage only works in certain cutscenes of an arbitrary limit. I'm actually slightly lower level than I like to be at the T-Rex, but it's okay. And actually, the T-Rex isn't even down in the gallery anymore, which is kind of silly in a anticlimactic way. It actually... What, did it go up the stairs? Did it climb the elevator to look for me up there? That doesn't make any sense. Here it comes. Does not look like there should be enough physical space for that to work, but it did. Alright. T-Rex time. You have to stay to its side, but I always forget which side. I think you want to stay to its left. Away from the way its tail curls, naturally. I think I want to stay to its left. So it has a hard time hitting me with stuff. Ooh, a little too far in front. Okay, so let's get him with a rocket. I wonder if my energy shot does more damage than a rocket. Oh, no, 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 get all the way back there. I'm gonna try an energy shot, see if I get more damage out. Because the damage between the rocket and the gun that I've been modding up is actually, there's not a whole lot of difference, and I haven't done any X games yet. I can't energy shot. Because I don't have a gun equipped, I got the rocket equipped. Alright, I guess we're rocketing him then. Who decided that dinosaurs should be allowed to breathe fire? That's what I want to know. There's a better attack spell that I wish I had access to, but I don't. Stay back here, Aya. Woo! She doesn't go through a reload animation for the rocket launcher either, it's just a slower weapon in general. Is behind it good? No, because he's going to jump and flip around. I probably could cast haste and be okay. That's alright, I won't need to. As long as I stay in the right spot and rocket him. Him stepping on me almost doesn't matter, it doesn't hardly do any damage. Oh, oh, but I got ticked by... 2 hits of fire damage there because I can't stay on the correct side of him with him in this area. Point blank rocket shot. Alright, we're gonna back off here. Make him jump to a different spot in the room. Like that! Now get up there before he burns you! Run, Aya, run! Made it! Alright. We're in semi-good shape. Now we need to make him jump again. No? No? I misread him. I thought we were going to have to make him jump again. Good thing we had all those med 4s. My goodness. The revive, I don't think it'll use unless I'm actually out of medicine. I don't think they're... Because you don't need to do anything special for revive. Wrong side. Oh, I got burned alive right there because I was on the wrong side of him. Rocket is underwhelming. I thought this rocket launcher was going to be better than it is. I've done too many X games with my rad super guns. No! He forced me to use a med 4 and he got me for 100 points of damage on top of that. The jerk. Alright, I probably need to switch my gun and energy shot him then. He's gonna be a turd about this. Wow, again with that. How many more med 4s do I have? Only a couple. I'm running low on rockets as it is. We're gonna go back to this. I'm gonna hit him for an energy shot, see if I can get a couple hundred damage in on him. He's gonna burn me alive right here, but it's okay. I'll live. There we go, 400 some damage, and that finished him off good. Level up! Liberates, that's what I was waiting for. And then that M8000, that's a good gun right there, man.